Today we're looking at a submerged electric turbine pump, and you can see there by the debris how high the water has got. Some of the areas that we'll look at with the pump today will be the switch gear or control gear, the motor itself, and the pump discharge, also the borehole assembly. This is a hollow shaft electric motor, and most hollow shaft electric motors are important to have air through them to cool them. The shaft goes up from the pump through the centre of that motor, and we've got a vent here and a vent at the top. So it's important to one, make sure that there's no debris closing those off, but in the case where it's been completely submerged, it's a good idea to remove the hollow shaft motor and have it looked at by a electrician. The electrical people will pull the motor apart and dry out all the bearings and wiring. The procedure to pull the motor off is that at the top there, under the hood, there's a adjustment nut with a locking screw. It's important to note where that locking nut is and where the locking screw is when you need to reassemble the unit. So it's just a matter of undoing that nut, and the shaft will drop down slightly, and you use the lifting lugs on the motor to lift that motor off the shaft. To lift the motor, you need something that's got a straight pull. A loader is very cumbersome to do something like that, because as it lifts higher, it pulls in closer to the tractor, which could bend the shaft.